In the realm of modern warfare, a deadly dance unfolds between advanced weapon systems, each vying for supremacy. On one side, we have sophisticated air defense systems like the Russian S400, designed to guard against aerial threats. On the other side stand long-range artillery systems like HIMARS and the ever-evolving capabilities of unmanned aerial vehicles or drones. This is a battle of stealth versus detection, of precision strikes against impenetrable defenses. The outcome of such confrontations can dictate the course of wars and shape the geopolitical landscape. Join us as we delve into the intricacies of these systems, comparing their strengths and weaknesses to determine who emerges victorious in this high-stakes standoff. But before we begin, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on future videos exploring the fascinating world of military technology and strategy. The S-400 Triumph, Russia's most advanced long-range surface-to-air missile system, stands as a formidable guardian of the skies. Entering service in 2007, this system represents a significant leap in air defense technology. The S-400 boasts an impressive arsenal of missiles, each tailored to engage a specific type of aerial target. These range from nimble fighter jets to lumbering bombers and even ballistic missiles. This versatility makes the S-400 a truly multifaceted air defense system, capable of countering a wide array of threats. Its sophisticated radar network provides early detection and tracking of enemy aircraft, while its powerful missiles can engage multiple targets simultaneously at impressive ranges. The S-400 is designed to operate in a networked environment, sharing data with other air defense assets to create a comprehensive and overlapping defensive umbrella. The High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, or HIMARS, presents a different kind of threat. This mobile artillery system, developed by the United States, is designed to deliver precise strikes against high-value targets from a safe distance. Unlike the S-400, which focuses on air defense, HIMARS is primarily an offensive weapon system. It can launch a variety of munitions, including guided rockets with a range of over 300 kilometers. This extended reach allows HIMARS to strike enemy targets deep behind their lines, disrupting their operations and degrading their ability to wage war. Its mobility adds another layer of complexity for adversaries, making it difficult to locate and neutralize HIMARS launchers before they can unleash their devastating payloads. The system's versatility and precision make it a valuable asset in various combat scenarios. Drones, or unmanned aerial vehicles, UAVs, have revolutionized modern warfare, providing an unparalleled ability to gather intelligence and strike targets with minimal risk to human operators. From small reconnaissance drones to larger armed drones capable of carrying out precision strikes, UAVs come in various shapes and sizes, each tailored to a specific mission set. Their ability to operate autonomously or under remote control makes them incredibly versatile and adaptable to changing battlefield conditions. Drones can loiter over areas of interest for extended periods, providing real-time intelligence to commanders on the ground. They can also be equipped with a variety of sensors, including high-resolution cameras, infrared imaging systems, and synthetic aperture radar, allowing them to detect and track targets, even in challenging environments. Section 5 S-400 versus HIMARS, a clash of ranges. In a hypothetical clash between the S-400 and HIMARS, the outcome would largely depend on the specific circumstances of the engagement. The S-400's long-range missiles, some capable of reaching up to 400 kilometers, give it a significant advantage in terms of engagement range. However, HIMARS compensates for its shorter range with its mobility and ability to shoot and scoot. This tactic involves quickly setting up the launcher, firing a volley of rockets, and then immediately relocating to a new position before the enemy can retaliate. Against a static target like an S-400 battery, HIMARS could potentially leverage its mobility and precision to launch a surprise attack. However, if the S-400 is adequately supported by other air defense systems and early warning radar, it could detect and engage incoming HIMARS rockets before they reach their target. Section 6, Intercepting the Swarm Drones versus S-400. The effectiveness of the S-400 against drones is a more complex issue. While the S-400 is designed to engage aerial targets, including UAVs, drones present unique challenges for air defense systems. Their small size, low radar cross-section, and ability to fly at low altitudes make them difficult to detect and track. The S400's radar system, while sophisticated, might struggle to differentiate between small drones and other objects like birds or clutter. Additionally, using expensive, long-range missiles to target relatively cheap drones is not cost-effective. Drones can also be employed in swarms, overwhelming air defense systems with sheer numbers. This tactic aims to saturate the enemy's defenses, allowing some drones to break through and strike their targets. To effectively counter drone swarms, air defense systems like the S400 require specific upgrades and tactics, such as integrating counter-drone lasers or electronic warfare systems. Section 7. Ukraine War Case Study, a Real-World Test. The ongoing conflict in Ukraine has provided valuable insights into the effectiveness of these systems in a real-world setting. While the S-400 has been deployed by Russia, its performance has been less than stellar. Ukrainian forces, equipped with HIMARS and drones, have successfully targeted and destroyed numerous Russian assets, including S-400 batteries. This demonstrates the importance of mobility, electronic warfare, and the element of surprise in modern warfare. It also highlights the evolving nature of air defense and the need for adaptable systems capable of countering a wide range of threats, including drones. Section 8. Beyond the horizon, future warfare and adaptations. The future of warfare will undoubtedly involve even more advanced iterations of these systems. We can expect to see further development of hypersonic missiles, directed energy weapons, and autonomous drone swarms. Air defense systems will need to adapt to keep pace, incorporating artificial intelligence, machine learning, and advanced sensor technology to counter these evolving threats. The constant cycle of innovation and adaptation will continue to shape the battlefield of the future. Section 9. Subscribe for more. Thank you for joining us on this exploration of modern military technology. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more in-depth analyses of military hardware, strategy, and the future of warfare. Stay tuned for more.